Okay, let's go ahead and start a new patient. Press create a new patient record. And these checkboxes are here because the system keeps track of how many new patients you see. So if it's basically you're transferring data from an established patient, you would uncheck this. And this brings up the new patient registration form, which we feel makes it easier to enter patient demographics. You click OK, and it brings open a form. Now, you start with the patient's first name. You can tab through these fields. So we're going to say this is Harry Williams. And I'm tabbing, push M for male. The date of birth, you want to use two digits for the day and month. So this 02151945, tab, social security number, tab, put the address in. And what's kind of cool is that you can put the zip code in and it automatically fills in the state. It's nice to have the email address in there so that when you do use the patient portal, it automatically will put that data in there. So it would be basically, let's go fix his name here. So we'll put him, his email address is harryw@gmail.com. So that's in there and it recognizes it. I just can't type Harry, can I? Okay, so then these are for meaningful use. So we'll put him as Hispanic or Latino, and that that he speaks English. Okay, so that's taken care of. So we save and close that. And it populates the information here. Now, to add the referring physician, you just simply double-click this space here, and it brings up whoever you have listed in there. If you want to add somebody, I'll show you how to do that later. But then you just pick somebody, or you go by last name. So if you put PEP and hit Enter, it would pick the closest one, and we put that in. Same with all these. If you want to add a new referring physician, you can click the button there and add a new physician record there like this. And again, it's good to put their email address in case you want to fax something to them later. Okay, so then this would normally default to your physician there. And that's basically how you put the basic information. Now let's suppose you wanted to go back and add some information. Under the extended demographics tab right here next to the home button is the quick edit patient demographics form. So I just put some basic things in, but if we scroll down, we can easily see here that we have room for the primary insurance, which would grab something that would be in your insurance library. And then you'd copy patient information down here if you wanted to basically indicate that it was the patient was a subscriber. You can put the secondary insurance in here and copy patient information down here. And again, it's helpful if you have all the information in about that insurance company. So that's basically how to start a new patient. Save and close that, and it populates wherever it needs to. Under these individual tabs, it'll put information in. As you see here, it's populated this information here. That's for easy, fast access to whatever you're looking for. So that's putting in the demographics. One thing we'd like to put in here is to find out what the source is, where the patient came from. And suppose they came from, if they came from somewhere that's not listed here, once you click here, like all drop-down boxes, you can add a new source in here. And once you add that new source, it will be available here, and you just pick whatever they came from. And that's it for adding a new patient.